My name is Dr. Jennie Valles. I'm a neurologist here at Burke Rehabilitation Hospital. Today, I will be discussing the changes that can occur to the gastrointestinal system after spinal cord injury. This entity is also referred to as neurogenic bowel. We will do a brief review of anatomy and follow with management strategies. In order to understand gastrointestinal and bowel dysfunction associated with spinal cord injury, let's begin with an overview of the anatomy and normal physiological function. The GI tract is a pathway food takes from the mouth through the esophagus, stomach, small, and large intestine. In the GI tract, nutrients and water from foods are absorbed into the bloodstream to help keep the body healthy. Whatever material isn't absorbed keeps moving throughout the colon until it is excreted by the body as stool. After spinal cord injury, a person may develop dysfunction in the GI tract, which is typically referred to as neurogenic bowel. These changes can have significant impacts to the health and quality of life of individuals living with spinal cord injury. The GI issues have the potential to worsen in time, which can result in declining health as well as increased hospital admissions. Individuals living with spinal cord injury may experience a variety of symptoms. Upper GI tract symptoms include nausea, early fullness, bloating, or abdominal pain. Lower GI tract symptoms, of which can be more distressing, include loss of sensation and or control of stool leading to fecal incontinence. These symptoms can be managed with a specialized bowel program. The goal of a bowel program is to achieve control in order to improve quality of life. By being in control, individuals with bowel dysfunction associated with spinal cord injury can minimize incontinence episodes by creating a plan to evacuate stools at a socially acceptable time and place. This will help to prevent complications such as skin breakdown or autonomic dysreflexia, a condition that causes periods of significantly elevated blood pressures. A good bowel program should also include the least amount of interventions. A comprehensive program for bowel management can include a combination of any of the following items. Keeping track of your food and fluid intake is important, as both can have effects on the consistency of stool and frequency of bowel movements. Often, management of neurogenic bowel requires a regimen of medications which typically include stool softeners, laxatives, and/or fiber supplements. Some patients have found benefit from performing gentle abdominal massage on themselves as part of the bowel program. Depending on the kind of neurogenic bowel you have, it might be necessary to perform manual, perianal, or rectal stimulation in order to remove stool. And in some cases, after careful consideration, surgical treatment may be required for managing bowel incontinence. Depending on the level and severity of one's spinal cord injury, one program, or at least components of a particular type of program, may be appropriate for an individual. An upper motor neuron neurogenic bowel will utilize reflexes that remain intact within the bowel musculature. Certain medications and techniques can trigger these muscles to move stool along the GI tract in a predictable fashion. For those with a lower motor neuron neurogenic bowel, such reflexes are absent. The mainstay of this program will rely on manual disinfection of stool and medications. The traditional upper motor neuron neurogenic bowel program is also called the 3-2-1 program. This program utilizes innate reflex activity. The components are as follows. 3 stands for colase 3 times a day. Colase is a stool softener. 2 stands for 2 Senna tablets 6 to 12 hours before rectal intervention. Senna is a stimulant that causes stool to move along the large intestine. 1 stands for 1 suppository, or mini enema, with digital stimulation. This stimulation takes advantage of the rectocolic reflex in 2 ways. There is both a chemical and mechanical stimulation to trigger the reflexes within the colon. The reflex will cause the colonic muscle to propel the stool along the GI tract until it is passed. This should be performed approximately 30 minutes to 1 hour after a meal to take advantage of the gastrocolic reflex. This is performed once a day or every 2 days. The goal's consistency of the stool should be somewhat soft. With a lower motor neuron bowel program, the anal sphincter is relaxed, so stool may tend to pass through easily or even cause leakage. For this reason, one may need to use medications to bulk up the stool, such as fiber. Senna can be used to increase large intestine motility. Therefore, there are no reflexes to take advantage of, and digital stimulation will not be helpful. Stool will need to be manually removed with your finger. You do not need to perform digital stimulation as the reflexes previously mentioned are not present. This is performed 1 to 2 times a day because of the increased chance of accidents with a relaxed sphincter. As previously mentioned, medications are often a part of an effective bowel program. Docusate, which is trade name Colace, is a stool softener that can be added to a medication regimen to ensure that the stools do not become too hard. Harder stools can take longer to pass, cause pain, and in rare instances, cause obstruction. Senna, trade name Senacot, is another common medication. It acts by stimulating the muscles in the colon to remove fecal material throughout the GI tract. As a reminder, this medication requires careful timing. Suppositories are another kind of bowel medication that are often used in a program. These medications are inserted into the rectum and act by stimulating the colonic muscle movements and reflexes in the gut. Fiber is sometimes used and added to a medication regimen to help add bulk to the stools. Stools that are formed move more easily throughout the colon. However, too much fiber can actually cause constipation. Enemas, such as water enemas or fleet enemas, are liquids that are inserted into the rectum. In some cases, surgical intervention can be explored. This should be carefully considered. Several surgical options have been used for bowel management following a spinal cord injury. These include the implantation of electrical stimulation systems, the formation of an elective colostomy, and the formation of an appendicostomy for the purposes of an antegrade enema administration. Surgical options should only be considered after other options have been exhausted. Expert advice should be sought if these procedures are being considered. In summary, bowel dysfunction is common after spinal cord injury. A good bowel program will be helpful in preventing medical complications, reducing hospital admissions, and maintaining quality of life. I have reviewed the nature of neurogenic bowel and recommended management strategies. I hope this information will be helpful. Thank you.